What is going on, guys? Today, I just got out of a job mandatory meeting. It's like almost 6 p.m. right now. So I'm thinking about doing maybe some chest and some triceps. And I rolled my ankle a couple days ago. I was walking down my buddy's steps and I landed wrong. So I don't know if I'm going to have my leg day on like Thursday or Friday or not. Don't know what day. But right now I'm just slamming some sweet potatoes. And got my workout book next to me. Just wrote down my workout. And this video, I'm going to do a vlog instead of a like actual talking during my workout video. I know that I have not posted any videos in a while, but now summer's coming around, school's a lot more like laid back, life is starting to balance its way out, so now making YouTube videos for you guys, for my clients, and the people that I motivate on social media is going to be a huge, huge priority of mine. So today, this workout is going to target pretty much a little bit of strength at the beginning, but I'm gonna break it down to isolating movements for muscle hypertrophy, causing my muscles to get bigger and allow more blood flow. So I hope you guys like this.
Yo guys, what is going on? The first exercise that we will be doing for this hypertrophy chest workout is obviously gonna be bench press. If you are not starting out your chest workout with a power movement trying to increase your strength, you're definitely doing it wrong. Okay, I'm just gonna tell it right to you guys, just down to the fucking bone. You have to start whatever muscle group that you're doing that day. Always do your Olympic / powerlifting, strength building lifts first. There's many reasons behind that, and if you guys have any questions, just let me know. Typically what I do is I'll do a warm-up set of just the 45 pound bar, you know, for 10 to 25 reps. And then after that, I will be doing a set between 15 and 25% of my working set as just a warm-up. So I was warming up with 135 and I was not expecting to, you know, go all up to 225. I was just doing my warm-up set based on a 205. So that's around that percentage that I was doing. Some days it'll be a little bit lighter, some days it'll be a little bit heavier. I always do between 5 and 7 sets, and my rep range for my first exercise would either be between 3 to 5, or I'm gonna be trying to get 5 reps on every single set. In this workout, I worked at the 225 and I was fucking amped. I have never hit 225 so easily before. So I did a little bit too big of a jump. I didn't have a spotter and I only got 4 reps of 245. It was pretty easy, but this pause right here, I feel it just drained me. I was not 110% confident in myself, and I got it up 90% of the way, but I just could not get it, barely missed it. So next week I'm definitely gonna be hitting 245 with ease for my 5 reps. You always gotta believe in yourself, and if you ever need anybody there, just ask for a spot. So I decided to take off a little bit of weight, drop back down to 225, and see if I could do my remaining 2 to 3 sets of just 225. And I did my 5th set, easily hit 5 reps. So then I decided to bump it up to, I believe, 235, and I hit 5 reps. So radio, I guess this guy wanted to spot me, and I did not know that he said that because my earbuds were in, I was blocking everything else out. So that's kind of funny how I just realized that as I was editing out this video. I'm sorry that my voice sounds so scratchy and so deep. You know, summer's coming around, allergies are kicking in. I'm getting a little bit sick, but it's not stopping me from just lifting my ass off, sticking to my regime, and starting to pump out some more YouTube videos. Right here, I bumped it up to 235. And I got an easy 4. In my 5th one, I was having just a little bit of trouble locking it out, but I still got it. So I was super pumped about that. Today was overall just a really good day for my chest workout. As soon as I hit that 205 for an easy 5 reps, I knew that it was going to be a little bit of a heavier day. If you guys ever have any questions on how to bench press, just let me know and I can make a video for you guys. I know that a lot of my clientele and a lot of people I train online or people that look up to me, they always ask me questions about bench press or deadlift, sometimes squatting, how to get big arms, stuff like that. So just let me know through a comment, through my fan page, through my email, anything like that. Just let me know any question that you guys have. So for my first set of my second exercise, which was an incline dumbbell press, you guys can see that I'm flaring all my elbows. Typically, you guys would not want to do this, but this is a really, really, really light weight, and I'm just warming up. So for me, it's just something that I like doing. I feel really solid flaring all my elbows for my warm-up sets. But once you guys get heavier, you guys are going to be dropping those suckers down as if you guys were just doing a normal barbell bench press. You always want to bring your elbows down to your sides and just drive straight up. And as you guys drive up, act as if you're trying to break the bar in half. That's going to activate your entire pectoralis muscle. And it's going to just overall help you guys optimally grow. Some of these clips, they're a little bit longer because I'm just getting my mindset in the game, getting that confidence booster and just banging them out. As you guys can see, when I'm doing my dumbbell press, I do not normally fully lock out. I always go down to my chest, but sometimes, I'd say a good 90-95% of the time, do not fully lock out because I feel a lot more stimulation on my chest when I do not fully lock out, especially with dumbbells. So you guys can either lock out or you guys can do my technique and just find that specific range of motion that just feels awesome for you guys.
Yeah, dude. That's your goal.
Alright guys, for the first set of you guys' final exercise, you're going to be finding a medium weight where you guys can do 15 to 20 reps. For me, I like to do this because it gets my blood flow going, it gets my mindset going, and I generally go pretty heavy. If I'm doing a weight where by the time that I'm either 3 to 5 reps out from my final rep goal, I will slow it down. And the way that I will do it is, let's say if I get 12 reps and I do not burn, my three remaining reps will be that rep range in seconds. So I will be holding my next rep for 13 seconds, my next rep for 14 seconds, and then my next rep for 15 seconds. When you guys are doing these, you want to make sure that the pulley is at your shoulder level, no higher and no lower. We're not trying to target our upper portion of our pectoralis or our lower portion more. We're trying to work them all the same amount. So by doing that, we will be doing that with a flat level or elevation. You guys always want to go nice and slow. We are not trying to build strength here. We're just trying to increase our muscle cell size. And we're just trying to really get our mind to muscle connection going and fill that fucker with some blood. These last sets are really going to take a lot of mind power and willpower to complete. But you just have to keep telling yourself that you're almost done. This right here is overall a really good balanced workout because you're going to be building some strength. You're also going to be building a lot of muscle hypertrophy also by the end of it. If this video was not so long, I would have added in a couple of supersets where after every single set of cable flies, I would have done as many push-ups as I could, either weighted or body weight. If you guys can do more than 20 push-ups body weight, then put a 35 or a 45 on your back and try to do some more. Anywhere between 8 to 15 reps.